that we're the elite, we're the best gene, and therefore we should do human engineering, the new science of man, so we reduce population to those of us who, number one, you know, have the elite minds, the pure genetics, and then we'll keep a small core of people to do the menial tasks that we don't want to do. And they even wrote about keep these people uneducated because there's no need to educate them. They're going to be doing menial tasks. And, you know, it's interesting reading these things because they were so open about it. And there's quite a few books on social control that are written in the 20s and 30s that openly talk about these
things. Edward Bernays and others. Stay there, Dr. Blaylock. Quick break. We're going to come right back to you. This is just so important, and we're so honored to have you here. Folks, I can't think of a more important subject. I hope you're telling your friends and family to tune into this live show and the rebroadcast. This is key. Imagine, folks, Dr. Blaylock, myself, so many other researchers. We know this information. I own close to 50 or so original source government textbooks and foundation textbooks where they say they're going to exterminate us. The United Nations Biological Diversity Assessment in 96, in 89. This is all public. It's just not widely known. This is true. This is real what we're talking about. They want us dead. And they are spraying us, the GMO. You know, there's hundreds of different types of plastics they can make inexpensively. They chose the one formula that releases these toxins, these endocrine disruptors that manipulate our hormone levels. Why did they choose that one type for universal adoption worldwide and sell the factory formulas and machines and systems, sometimes at a loss, to make sure that was implemented in the 50s? Then we see the sperm counts drop. We see the fertility problems. Why do they approve the bovine growth hormone to put in the milk when they know it's linked to cancer and all these problems? Why do they put mercury in vaccines? You know, we've gotten up to the point of their master plan, Dr. Blaylock. This is a short segment. I want to come back in the next long segment and take some calls from Jen and Sherry and Robert and Brad and Dr. Tracy and others that are holding. But there's so many. We talked for 10 hours. I'm going to definitely have you back if you'll grace us with your time to warn people. What do we do about this? I mean, we're here trying to warn folks. This is real. This affects everybody, except for a few thousand elitists who even write about how they know they're being hurt by the blowback, but it's okay for the greater work they're doing. I mean, how do we counter this?
Well, it's very difficult because, like I say, they have the entire wealth of the world at their disposal. They essentially control all the media. I mean, back in 1950s, a guy by the name of Manuel Josephson, who was a medical doctor, he wrote a book on Rockefeller that's quite detailed, very well documented. And he talks about these things in that book as well, how Rockefeller was absolutely obsessed with controlling all information that's available to the public. And the way he did it, even back then, he was spending something like $250 million controlling the media. And by being the major controlling force in literally hundreds, if not thousands, of corporations, all of which advertised in the major media, by 1950s, all the major media was dependent on their advertising dollar. So anything he wanted in the media and anything he didn't want in the media, all he had to do is let them know, well, you would lose your funding if that's discussed.
And a lot of other mainstream media was owned by allies like William Randolph Hearst. Doctor, let's take this tack for a moment and then continue with any other points you had on that first question. There are elitists and wannabe elitists, a lot of these minion professors. And I use the local Austin example of Dr. Eric Pianca. He gives speeches, it's been in the news, where he says we need to kill 90% of the public. And the news, the point is, they get 95% standing ovations. He PowerPoints a huge thing of skulls with a red filter on the wall. This has been on national news. And everybody claps, and the scientists cry. And he goes and speaks to the Royal Academy in England and to the big, you know, Royal Academies and the most prestigious academies in France. I know you've written papers and spoken to some of those big groups as well, but the point is, and the majority of them start crying. This has been in the newspaper because this is their religion. What do you want to say to those people listening? I mean, what would be your counter and your argument to them? I mean, reaching out to them and going, my God, look what you've done. I mean, trying to get them to come over to our side of humanity.
Well, you know, this is the collectivist idea, and we're steeped in collectivism. This was the whole program of virtually every president since the Civil War, is the gradual implementation of collectivism in the United States. And collectivism basically says the individual doesn't matter. What matters is the community. Well, community doesn't really mean a lot. If you listen to communist jargon, they say the people. We speak for the people. Well, this mythological people is nobody. It's whoever's in charge, whoever owns the gun. And so the government owns all the power, and so they speak for the people. They speak for the public. So when you hear them saying, this is for the good of the public, or this is good for the...
And then in reality, the eugenicists, the communists, they always kill the people because they hate the people.
Well, they fear the people. You know, historically, if you look at every dictatorship, what eventually happens is they come to fear the people because they know that what they're doing is unpopular and not working, and then they fear revolution.
Yes.
And this is what happens with collectivism in the United States, is it becomes more and more collective. People recognize the elitist is now what's causing my financial failure, or the leaders are what's causing, you know, whatever bad is
the
happening.
The parasite. Stay there, doctor. Stay there. We got a break. We'll be right back after this quick break with Dr. Russell Blaylock. Stay with us.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold for your IRA? The financial industry refuses to recognize the value of real hard assets for your retirement. The truth be told, gold and silver has outperformed paper investments like stocks, bonds, and CDs, yet no word about IRAs. Perhaps the financial institutions want to maintain control of your assets by keeping you in paper. If you'd like to take a look at gold for your retirement, call 800-686-2237. Don't get left behind by rising inflation and low return on your paper investments. Call 800-686-2237. Make sure that you secure your future. Call 800-686-2237. That's 1-800-686-2237.
There's a need for a new world order. Someday, in the next few years, a solution will emerge.
You have been warned. All of you out there listening, we'll give you the documents. I made the film Endgame. Dr. Blaylock's made films, written books, all sourced. Psychopathic control freak killers are in control of our society. They're setting up world government. They're engineering the financial collapse, in their own words, to bring in total control, where every facet of your life will be controlled, where you'll pay carbon taxes for everything you do, where bureaucrats will run your life, youth brigades. The list goes on and on and on and on. You just heard Walter Cronkite talking about at the right hand of Satan. You just heard Henry Kissinger calling for world government. You heard Fox News saying children are bad. This is the program. I want to tell the police and military that serve the New World Order. Most of you don't understand this. You better learn it. You are being poisoned and killed as well. Dr. Blaylock, I want to go to calls. But let's say you had 3 minutes on national TV to address the public about the program, the toxins, the poisons, what's in their food and water, and how to avoid it. If you had 3 minutes to boil it down and warn people, because this will be seen, it's being heard by millions, you know, watched on the web right now by thousands, it'll be seen by millions in the aggregate just in the next few weeks as folks put this interview out everywhere. You've got 3 minutes before we go to call, sir. What is most important for people to know about how dire this is, how real this is?
Well, what they need to know is that the authorities, the people who are defending these things like vaccination, the thimerosal, the fluoride in the water, they never have a defense against the charges that are being made. They never even attempt to answer these questions. when I challenge these people on vaccination, they won't even appear on radio to challenge me. I did that in Hawaii. We challenged the public health to come on and debate what I had to say. They wouldn't even appear because I know something that the other people talking about vaccines are not talking about, and that is when you vaccinate with these large numbers of vaccine, it activates the brain's special immune system and will destroy the connections in the brain, alter the development of the brain. And this is why we're seeing so many of these brain disorders and learning difficulties in our children. Now, these things are backed up by enormous research, thousands of studies all over the world by independent researchers. It's not that the research is not there and the proof is not there. It's that the media won't carry it. None of the major publications will carry this story. They won't interview you. They don't want to have this exposed. So we're having to use the other outlets, like the Alex Jones Show, and to get this to the public. It's very well documented. If you look at my website, you'll see a lot of references. You read my books. Everything is referenced.